just one student learns the beauty of aesthetics, then that's fine, I need only one. Or if one student learns the wonders of poetics, then he's mine and my work here will be done. And if one student values structure, learns that words can be valuable and fun, show me 20 students who despise the poems they have to memorize. All right, I need only one. And if one student learns that books can be ecstatic, what the heck, I don't need romance. If I've wasted my life being firm and autocratic, I'm a speck in an orbiting expanse. What I did was always well-intentioned, and what's done, folks, is ultimately done. Give me 80 students who deplore the fact that I demanded more. Screw 'em! I need only one student who rarely watches television. One student who understands the value of precision. Are there limits to my teaching? Was I always overreaching? Probably I was. And so what if I was? I've been told that my life is ending very shortly. That's all right, I do not like scenes. Since I'm not someone's wife and I don't have any children, I won't fight or be hooked up to machines. But for that special kid who liked me, you laughed at an inauspicious pun. Let him fondly ponder who I was and represent me well, because there'll be only one. There'll be only one. There'll be only one. Only one. The fact that I'm prickly and derisive, that I will and not make amends. I was born without tact, I was born to be decisive, and I still don't have very many friends. But I taught what I knew needed teaching. If they fought me, they learned who held the gun. So whose students always did the best on every statewide essay test.